Yeah. They did you a favor, you know. And sometimes we take it to heart and we take it the wrong way, because for somebody to even do that to you, they gotta be close. They gotta be a close person, you know what I'm saying? So you take it to heart at first, but while you taking it to heart, or after you take it to heart, sit back and analyze it. Sit back and do that self-evaluation, you know, and check the situation, you know what I'm saying? And go down that checklist on this person, you know what I'm saying? With me, I had to realize people been flaky. You know, people just switched up on me. They was just looking for a way, you know, to project it and carry it out. But you been flaky. You know, motherfuckers will never stand down for you. Motherfuckers will never cheer you on. Motherfuckers will expect the worst out of you and are surprised when you do, you know, prevail or do good. You know what I'm saying? You gotta watch out for it. You know what I'm saying? The people that don't applaud for you, you know, and they seem happier when things go out of whack. You know what I'm saying? So I had a lot of those people around. I had a lot of people that didn't get down for me, didn't stand by my side. And, you know, if they don't stand by your side, they do more bystanding than standing with you. You know what I'm saying? Onlooking and shit, you know. And I say that because I'm the type of person and which, you know, people can't be real like me, man. You know what I'm saying? They can't be real like you, you know. Everybody can't do what comes natural to some of us, you know. If I'm rocking with you, I'm rocking with you. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully you can make your own way to get something to eat. But if you hungry, if you starving, you ain't gonna starve. You know, I got your back. You know what I'm saying? If you just need a person, I got your back. So like I said, you know, people like fence straddle. I had a lot of fence straddling people. Don't choose my side. Don't never show up for me. Am I ever the one where they say, oh, no, you know, and back me? You know, so you got to go down that checklist on these people. You know, was they there for me in this situation? Did they stand up when I needed this? Did they come through when I needed them for this? And you go down that list and you realize, like, you know, a lot of times you realize, like, damn, this person ain't never really been down for me. This person ain't never really been down with me, you know. They'll switch up, you know, like they'll switch up like how a female will do that you're kicking it with, you know what I'm saying? I can't say like a girl, because some of the people I'm talking about in my particular situations are girls, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, some people are weaker in spirit and weaker, you know, in integrity. And you gotta realize that. And, you know, that's just the way it go. You know. So, yeah. I just wanted to share that with y'all. So, it did you a favor sometimes. Sometimes it's more of a blessing, you know. And, of course, it's a shock when there's people that's close to you and people that you expect to be the same as you, that you think you share a mutual thing with each other, but it's not. It's one-sided sometimes, and sometimes we're loyal to a fault. Sometimes we're blind to the fact, and that's exactly what I was with a lot of people. And I had this situation, not a situation, but I had to think about it. Like, my grandmother, she raised me, 8 brothers and sisters, and it was rough sometimes. Sometimes I was cutting grass and shoveling snow just to feed the family. Sometimes we were without gas, without lights, burning the fireplace all the time, barbecuing all the time, because that's what we had. You know what I'm saying? We was really, you know, I'm really from that, you know, humble beginnings, how they say it, you know, to make it a lighter term. But it was a lot going on. It was a lot of people that was in their own way, to put it as delicate as possible. A lot of things went on that was wow, you know, and a lot of latch on to the big house granny had, and you know, Granny was Granny with all of it. But I sat her down one day and I asked her, particularly about me and my brothers and sisters. I said, Granny, you know, it was rough. You know, this is later years, maybe when I was 16, 17 years old. And I asked her, I said, you know, why'd you go through all that? Why you do that? And she looked in my eye and she said, because you are mine. And I live like that. And I understand what she meant. You know what I'm saying? I take ownership. Not ownership in the way of controlling you, but ownership in the responsibility of holding you up, and the responsibility of making sure you're on a upward rise, and not nevertheless, you know what I'm saying? I'm here for you because you're mine. You know what I'm saying? And I'm right for mine, you know? And I understood where she came from, and that's maybe that's where I got it from, you know. But everybody ain't like that, and sometimes we just want to believe that the people, even sometimes brothers and sisters, you know, people we've been with all our lives, sometimes you might be the one that got the heart still, and you don't see that these people are not the same, and they don't have your best interests at heart, and they won't put their neck on the line for you, and they won't stand out for you, and they'll switch up. And when the switch up comes, you might want to be surprised. You might be surprised, but it's really no surprise. Sometimes it's no surprise. It's just finally they did something real for you by excluding themselves for being less than what you were to them. So they did you a favor. They did me a favor. Like I said, I saw my old friend and it made me think about everybody and a lot of people who I hadn't connected with in years. And they flaked on me. You know, there's no way around it. And they've been flaking on me. And they've been fence strappers. And they've been not riding with me how I ride with them, and not sticking with me like I stick with them, and standing up for me like I stand up for them. They've been less, you know. And I'm all about the more, nevertheless. You know, and that's what my granny meant when she said, you're mine. I'm all about more for you. I'm all about life for you. They can't just treat you any type of way. They can't just talk to you any type of way. They can't just give you any type of thing, because I'm here for you, and I'm here for that. You did. They can't just, not mine. And that's what my granny was on, and that's what I've been on, and that's what family supposed to be on, and that's what friends supposed to be on. And if they ain't on that, and they get the flaking out and switching up on you, and you get to say, damn, right? Damn, it's like that. Oh, they saying this. Oh, they acting like, yeah, they doing you a favor, baby. Take the blessing. Take the nod. Thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Almighty Most High, the Almighty I Am, for clearing it up for me. You know, and the crazy thing is, I still love them. You know, still love them. But hey, my eyes are opened. My eyes are opened. And now, when people deal with me, I'm more keen on it. I see it. You gotta deal with me correctly, baby. Or you ain't gonna get the real me. You know, if you get me at all. Peace, y'all. You know, stay up, stay positive, stay inspired. Stay motivated, stay moving, stay ducking the bullshit, stay deflecting. You feel me? You know, it's 2023, man, and I'm on my grind. I'm on my mental. I'm on my getting myself in the right space and staying centered. I'm on my spiritual, and I'm on my integrity and trying to be righteous. And I'm on for my kids, you know? It's all love. It's all love. Stay away from the negativity. Stay away from the negativity and the toxicness out here. You know, hopefully I keep making more videos. I don't make them all the time. I make them very rarely. And that's how you know they mean something important to me. I'm not just making them on the spur. It's when thoughts hit my mind, thoughts are heavy on my heart or whatever. You know what I'm saying? That's when I get to making them and sharing them. So here you go, YouTube, and, you know, hopefully something come up of this or whatever, you know, hopefully soon I'll be back in the studio putting it in its rhyme form, but the feeling got to be there, the real fuel got to be there. I can't just, you know, I can't fake everything, you feel me? All right, y'all, love.